Hey guys, and welcome to this video. In this video, I will show you some images I took of the biggest planet in our solar system, Jupiter. I will also guide you through the way this picture was stacked and processed. Alright, I'll start with my equipment. I use an 8-inch Newtonian telescope on a Skywatcher HEQ 5 Pro. My camera is the ZWO-RC178MC Color. This is a color camera and I therefore save myself a lot of work when processing the images. However, this does also lower the number of pixels available. So, after setting up my telescope, I made three different captures. One with 5000 frames, one with 10,000 and one with 40,000 frames. At the end of the video, I will compare the final images of every single capture. For now, we're going to work with the 40,000 frames one. As I have already shown in my tutorial on stacking and processing planetary images, I will open AutoStackered. Okay, so I have it open now, and we will first of all select this 40,000 frames capture and load it into AutoStackered right here. Now, for this first point, we are going to select planet as we have a planet. Leave the other things as they are and hit analyze. Okay, it's finished now. It took roughly 2 minutes and we now have our footage analyzed and we see this quality graph. Now we have to decide what percentage of frames we want to stack. And if we click here, we can now see that the top 2.2% are around these images. So from the left here, so they have a very good quality. And then the 5% I select it would be around here. So more frames, but low quality. And 10% is around there. So once again, we're still above the 50% quality line here and a lot more pictures now. We will want to double stack, leave that on auto size. We won't sharpen it in auto stacker. We'll do that later in Registacks. We do want the RGB align in this free field. You can just type in a name. And now we go over to this window. And here we'll have to set the alignment points. So for the size, I'm going to go down to 16 and then just let it place. And it does that automatically. And we can hit stack. Okay, so that was rather quick. And we'll now go into this folder right here and we have our three pictures, so the 2% one, the 5% one, and also the 10% one. Okay, so right now these look really similar and we will now go into the software Registacks and work with those pictures further. So for this video I'm just going to go with the 2% one here and show you my workflow on this picture. So just go in full image to get it large. And now we'll have to do a few things. First of all, we notice that Jupiter is pretty orange here. And to kind of like get rid of that, you can use this RGB balance tool. And if you just go on auto balance, it now has a lot clearer colors. And this will make a huge difference later in the final image. So the next step is to go to wavelet here. And now we have these layers. And if we just go with the first layer here, let's say around 70, you can already see it's a lot sharper. And we can even go on sharpen here. Now we have to pay attention that this doesn't get like too harsh of a contrast. So we can also use this denoise setting to smooth that out a little bit. And now it's just a process of working with these layers and settings and just testing what works best for your picture. Okay, so I think I've got pretty good settings for this picture now. And you can already see the great red spot here on Jupiter. What you might find what happens in this process is that one edge gets slightly blue, like this edge up here, so the top right corner. And you can go to RGB align, and try to fix that here. So right here you can shift these blue and red layers. So if I do this to the extreme, you can see that it separates blue and yellow here. So obviously that's way too far. But let's just go back to zero here, and maybe like one is enough. So you can see we've got the same problem now just on the other side. So it doesn't really work here. Maybe the Y position. Okay, that was the wrong direction. Okay, well now we just got this yellow outline, which also isn't pretty. So I think for this picture it's best to just leave it as it was. But if it's extreme in your picture, you can definitely work with this RGB alignment tool. Okay, now that we've done that, we are finished with our picture and can hit do all and save image. And I'm just going to name this underscore regstacks and hit save. All right. Now we'll compare these two pictures, so this 2% one and the 2% one, but processed in Registax. Just going to zoom in a bit, and we can see a huge difference. So in this picture, you might be able to see the red spot a little bit here, but over here it's really clear, and this is just way sharper, and all the different lines of Jupiter come out a lot better in this picture. I'm now going to do the same process with the 5% and 10% stack, and also with the 5K and 10K capture. After I've done that, I will compare the images and we can decide on which looks best. Okay, so I'm finished with the pictures from the 40,000 frames capture. And here we have the 2, 5, and 10% stack, and there really isn't much of a difference. And I think they all look very similar, but maybe the 2% one looks just a bit better than the others. But this might also come down to the process in Registax and how you process these images. So, just as a reminder, a very important part of processing is done in Registax with these wavelets. And you really want to make sure to experiment with that and get that just right. All right, now to the 20,000 frame stack. Here I only have two images, so we have 5% and 10%. And again, these two look very, very similar, and it's really hard to make out any real differences between these two. So we're going to compare these to the 40,000 frame pictures now. Now, just as a side note, I did capture more of the space around Jupiter in the 20K footage. And in a direct comparison between the 20K and the 40K, I would say that in the 40K frame picture, the edges are a little clearer. So I think I prefer this picture, but they are really similar. And as a side note, you can see that the big red spot moved just a little. So in the 20,000 frame exposure, it was more on the left side. And in the 40,000 frame exposure, it moved further into the middle of Jupiter. So if you want to make sure that you capture the big red spot when you image Jupiter, you can use a software such as Stellarium. And if we just go through these times here, so with this date and time window, you can select the hour at which you're imaging Jupiter. And if we click through these minutes, you can see how Jupiter rotates. So you can kind of like plan ahead when you want to image Jupiter to capture that part of Jupiter you want to image. All right, now we get to the 5,000 frames exposure. So as you can see, this is a very wide view image. And we have Jupiter with four of his moons around him. And again, I have a 20% stack and a 10% stack. However, the differences are marginal, and it really comes down to processing in Registax how your final images will turn out. And again, if we compare the 5,000 frames image to the 40,000 frames one, there isn't much of a difference. So both of these images are pretty good. So again, I think the 40,000 frames image is a little clearer. Okay, so there we have it. I hope you liked my images of Jupiter. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments and I'll try to answer them. If you want to dive deeper into how processing and stacking planetary images works, I can recommend you this video right here. And thank you so much for watching Clear Skies.